Carl Jennings, I come from Waianae.
Watch out.
Significance of that picture is you will never see a school of fish or bakuri shaped like a koi pond. The significance of that is the resource is telling you good fishing is to come. You know,
it's another
picture. Pokai too. Some more fish out in the sand. This is Makaha. What I'm trying to do right now is just establish.
See the fish.
Habitat, yeah. This is Makua. This is Kialaula. This is Cattle Pen, Barber's Point. And I want to talk about that a little bit. If you look at the canal was put there for flood control. And if you look at the canal on the southwest side of the canal, you see all that white, it's all sand. Mm-hmm. The sand that was dredged out of the canal, the thing goes up about 250 yards into the canal. The sand outside, I've been fishing from the 70s, the sand came from a sand hole outside that used to support schools of Ahololo and Akuli. Half of the sand is gone, half of the sand is inside there. They dredged it all out and they left it there. They two big mounds on the corner and get sand all the way down the side of the canal, all the way inside a couple hundred yards in. So, you know, 30 years we depended on that spot. Half of the sand gone, the fish not coming in anymore in that particular area. The only other place you get over there is this. We get two places, Ever Beach and then a place called Kalailoa. Right outside the Coast Guard Station. That's the sand hole. That's what a sand hole is supposed to look like. This is for Santa Claus Rome, Swailupi. It's another place where Akuli come. There's mad meat, there's mud bottom, mud sand. Akuli go inside all the time. Potluck is another place. Potluck is a natural habitat for Akuli. This is why Manalo. Yeah. I wanted to just talk about, you know, we're talking about gallons of sand, but I'm talking about laws that force us to remove sand. You know, maybe Ed can talk a little bit about it, but they just got through dredging the Waianae Boat Harbor. And I don't know how many hundreds of yards or thousands of yards that they moved from that harbor, but that sand came from someplace. And then they put it up on the shore, and then I don't know, rumor to me was the sand was taken to the dump because it was contaminated. This could be anywhere from 500 to 1,500 yards of, I mean, huge amount of sand, you know, that is not going back into the environment, that is going somewhere else. Mm-hmm. In the picture I showed you, that's another one with the canal, sand all going up inside the canal. They don't put it back into the environment where the thing belongs, where it supports the resources. The sand is there for a reason. If you saw that movie, The Predator, you know, that movie was bogus because that predator should have, from the sun, that predator should have thrown a shadow. No matter what kind of magic he had, he should have thrown a shadow on the trees or whatever. But that's why dolphin, Akuli, Opelo, all the different resources that favor the sand are in the sand. Because the predator, the tiger shark, the barracuda, always they have a gift. If they're 50, 60, 70 yards away, you will never see them. They're invisible. What gives it away is a shadow that it throws on the sand that the resources can see. It's a natural protection why they favor the sand. Yeah. So, we're talking about 1 gallon, but you know, you see how much sand getting pulled out of the environment just by the law or by development. So, you know, I thought it was important to come talk a little bit about the sand. And, you know, in fact, I started fishing in the 70s, and there's two sand holes. One sand hole on Haleakala, that after 30 years, I don't, that sand is gone. And there's another sand hole, cabanas, Makaha cabanas, that sand hole is gone. It's very shallow sand hole, 1-2 feet deep, but it's entirely gone. So where the sand went after 30 years, I cannot tell you, but the sand is disappearing.
I don't think he's here.
Thank you.
Thank you.